is the wrap up. Or, well, no, it's not the wrap up. It's the lunchtime roundup. I'm all a bit flustered because we've been doing heavy lifting.
We have indeed, mate.
We've moved offices. This is our new office. We're in sort of on today. If you were to look that way, you'd see a lot of computers being set up, a lot of wires. Me and Andy have dipped out to do the lunchtime video because A, we were committed to the lunchtime video, and B, set up computers is a bit boring.
And we've done all the heavy lifting.
I had to hire a van and drive it, and me trying to park it in Liverpool City Centre, where we should have videoed that and just put that up, to be honest with you. A 700-point turn. If you can imagine Austin Powers trying to turn that thing round, and back of it, front of it, that was me trying to park. And anyone who's been around the town hall will tell you it's not easy. But yeah, we did it and we're in.
What'd
you think? Well, it's very nice. It's a big office. We're sharing it with our mates at Red Touch. They've got a Liverpool office, so we've moved in with them. Just to make sense. So it is very nice. So you'll see more of it throughout the weeks and months, I'm sure. But this is a little office space that we've ducked in to do this and to do a bit of news. And also, well, it's a busy day for us. We're going to press comments later as well, aren't we?
We are. Certainly, I'm going up to Melwood.
Yeah,
so they're letting us in.
I don't know how it's happened. Well, I mean, we presume they're letting us in. They still might not. But
they're just fed up with me.
Yeah. So 2:15, that is. So we'll do some tweets from there and a few pictures. We probably won't do too much. And we'll record the full audio and put that out for subscribers. So you'll be able to, our subscribers will be able to hear the full audio of that later on today. I probably won't ask him any, and I'll probably just play it cool. It's my first one. So I don't want to annoy the top end, you know, the Barrett of this world, you know what I mean? The real class. I don't want to be annoying them, you know. I've heard James Pearce is quite handy, so I don't want to upset him early. So I'm just gonna sit there and play it cool and let Melissa ask all the questions. But you know, we'll see if he looks at me and says, "I want you. You look like it. You look like you know what you're on about."
I think he'll recognise you.
I'll do a bit. If you want to know my thoughts, I'll give you them. But that's 2:15, so we're heading up there now. And as I say, we'll get the full audio off of that. Just in terms of general news, I guess the big one is we've got a new fitness coach. His name is Andreas Kornmeyer. He's from Bayern Munich. He's very highly thought of.
He sounds dead hard,
and he's. He's been credited a lot with helping out a few lads like Ribéry at Bayern. He've had a few injury problems, and he's good at strengthening and conditioning, apparently. So it just all this says to me, Andy, that it all points to a big pre-season and the fact that they want to get them very, very fit pre-season and very, very ready for the style of football he wants to play.
Can be like Police Academy 7, isn't it?
Would you say so?
Yeah, I think so. Running up and down hills and, you know. I'm still open.
Is it a hill in Melwood?
No, but there isn't form. But I'm going to say it's a Pinewoods thing because you took them into the forest.
Do you know what? Like, all the North East clubs, they always take them on the beach. And I think everyone else is missing a trick. I mean, to be fair, North East football isn't exactly flying at the moment. So maybe I'm wrong on this. But you always see, like, the Newcastle players on Boxing Day running on the beach. And Middlesbrough were doing it the other day. Formby Beach, get them on there, running up the sand hills.
There you go.
You know, that'll sort them out.
Yeah, big
so
time.
There you have. We boxed it for you, Jürgen. So, it's all reft. All go for tomorrow or getting up to there. We've obviously done a competition. It's closed now. We're just picking four winners. Well, four finalists, should I say, and we're going to let Twitter decide because we can't decide because there were so many good entries. So my wife's actually gone through them now, picking the best eight, which we'll whittle down to four, and then we'll let Twitter decide. But we will be able to let the winner know by about 4 or 5 o'clock today. And just to... I mean, get there early tomorrow anyway. Get there early if you are going to get the atmosphere. But just to so everyone knows, there's going to be a minute of silence tomorrow as well before the game. It's the day before the Hillsborough anniversary. So there will be a minute of silence before the game tomorrow. So it's always a bit awkward walking in during that anyway. So make sure you're there early. But get there night early anyway. And make sure it's a brilliant atmosphere. Is that all right?
Yeah, we're all good.
All right.
Got a packed day. Got to run.
Packed day. Got to run. Loads of good stuff for you later. Cheers.